The first question America wants to know, are you clean right now?
Look at me, duh. Drug tests don't lie.
When was the last time you did drugs?
Don't remember, don't care. Drug tests don't lie. Scoreboard doesn't lie.
You say you've cured yourself
yes.
of addiction. You don't need yes, Alcoholics Anonymous. How have you done that?
I closed my eyes and made it so with the power of my mind.
Did you turn to alcohol and other substances because you were bored?
No, I did that because they work.
You've been to rehab before. This time you did in-home rehab. First of all, what is that? And why did it work, you think, this time for you?
Well, we couldn't really call it rehab because we didn't have a license to operate one, so it was a crisis management center that we labeled the Sober Valley Lodge.
You labeled your house the Sober Valley Lodge?
Well, yeah, that's what it became.
So what happened?
And we wouldn't allow AA to be a part of it. We wouldn't allow AA to contaminate Sober Valley Lodge, and as a result, its primary client achieved radical success.
You told me you want to rededicate yourself now to your kids, to being a dad.
Sure.
Are you embarrassed that your children will read about this one day?
God, no. It's talking about an education. And then like this, and then that's the guy, and he's our dad, and we can get all the answers and the truth. Wow, winning. It's how you perceive it.
Didn't CBS have a right to shut your show down? They're reading about you partying at all hours of the night, taking drugs, abusing alcohol. It's their show.
Epic. Epic behavior. No, because after reading about that, then they observed a guy hitting every mark, nailing every line, every joke, with a full house, screaming.
Ever miss a day of work?
Not a day that cost anybody any money. I missed practice. We're talking about practice. To quote the great Allen Iverson, practice. Come on, guys, we're talking about practice. I'm tired of pretending like I'm not special. I'm tired of pretending like I'm not bitching a total frickin' rock star from Mars. And people can't figure me out. They can't process me. I don't expect them to. You can't process me with a normal brain. Like I said, I'm a man of my word. So I will finish the TV show. I'll even do season 10. But it's at this point, because of psychological distress, oh my God, it's 3 mil an episode. Take it or leave it.
Oh, so you want to raise?
Well, yeah, look what they put me through.
So you make $2 million an episode now.
Roughly, that includes the back end, yeah.
And you want $3 million now?
Well, because I'm underpaid right now, sure.
You're underpaid?
If you look at the money they're making, yeah, it's ridiculous.
A lot of your fans have been worried about you, worried
well,
about your health.
They can worry all they
are
want,
you,
but
are you going to OD? Are you going to die?
That's for amateurs. Come on, no, I'm fine. I've always had a plan, and I've always executed it perfectly. Sometimes I overshoot the mark, whatever.
How do you avoid slipping back into that again?
I don't know, I just won't do it. I mean, that's... I will not believe that if I do something, then I have to follow a certain path because it was written. And it was written for normal people, people that aren't special, people that don't have tiger blood and, you know, Adonis DNA.
Do you owe CBS an apology?
No. They owe me a big one, publicly, while licking my feet. And if people think I'm insane or they don't think that what I'm saying is true, then I have no interest in their retarded opinions. I really don't, you know. I'm going to live my life the way I want. I'm going to win inside of every moment and they can just find the most comfortable chair in their small house and sit back and enjoy the show.